when Olga brought him in. I've checked everything, including the genome data, but there's nothing on this guy. NSA, CIA, FBI. He doesn't exist in any database. He's a non-existent operative from a non-existent organization.
I suspected as much. However, I know this man. Wake him up. It's been a while, hasn't it, Jack the Ripper?
You know this fellow?
You remember me, don't you? You've grown. High concentration of cerebral implants. Have they altered your memory, too? This is my son. I taught him everything. Jack, I never thought I'd see you again.
You know me?
You don't remember. Your name, your skills. Everything you know, you learn from me. The 80s. A civil war. You were one of the best among the child soldiers that fought in that conflict. When you were barely 10 years old, you became the platoon leader of the small boy unit. At the time, your outstanding kill record earned you several nicknames, including White Devil and Jack the Ripper. Jack, I was your godfather. I named you. When the war ended, you disappeared from the relief center. I wondered what happened to you. I should have known they would recruit you.
It's an interesting coincidence.
If he's a lackey for the Patriots, I doubt he knows anything of interest.
What should we do with him?
We'll use him like you suggested.
What about Dead Cell?
Ignore them. Happening again?
Could it be that he's here too?
In another hour, we demonstrate the power of Arsenal gear.
Attack with standard weapons, of course.
Yes, proceed as planned.
At last report, all is well with GW.
How about the troops?
The men are being refitted with Arsenal gear equipment as ordered. You're the spitting image of Big Boss.
Is that so? Perhaps I should be grateful to this kid for that.
This situation, I find it very nostalgic.
Where am I?
Why, inside Arsenal gear, of course. Actually, we're also inside the memory of Shadow Moses. I'll take this back. You don't need this anymore, do you? A foul wind is blowing. We shall speak again.
Don't move. Stay as you are. We're being monitored by a camera.
What are you up to?
I'm switching over to nanocommunication.
Mr. X? Ninja?
Correct. It's me.
I thought you were the leader of the Russian troops.
No, that was just a smokescreen.
A smokescreen?
I was sent to provide you support.
Support? Who sent you? The Colonel?
No, the Patriots.
What?
I deceived my troops, betrayed them.
But why?
My child is being held hostage by the Patriots. It all started 2 years ago when I lost my father during the tanker incident. My men and I had nowhere to go, so we joined forces with an illegal Russian organization.
The Russian Mafia?
Something like that, actually. I learned much later that it was a subordinate organization of the Patriots. I was expecting at the time. When I gave birth to my child, it turned out I was in a hospital run by the Patriots. In the morning, my child was gone. My baby is being kept somewhere in this country.
Have you ever met your child?
No. Once a month, they send me a photo of my child via network. I've never even held the child in my own arms.
I see. Given your situation, nobody can blame you for what you did.
That's your opinion.
What about Snake? I thought you were enemies.
He wasn't responsible for my father's death. Actually, we owe him our lives. 2 years ago, they were responsible for getting us out of the sinking tanker alive.
So you were partners since the incident?
No, I only found out the truth shortly before this.
Huh?
When I confronted him here.
You fought with Snake? When?
Well, it was around the time you were holding hands with that girl.
Snake. So you joined hands with him to pay back a debt?
No, mutual gain.
Mutual gain?
My job was to assist you. If Solidus gets away with Arsenal, your mission is a failure. The Patriots would judge that as failure on my part and terminate my child. Putting it simply, my child's life depends on your success.
So you did it all for your child. But why would the Patriots want to help me? Are they hoping I'll take Solidus out?
No, you're just like me. We're just pawns.
Pawns for what purpose?
The S3 plan.
Huh?
You'll figure it out sooner or later. But I wonder if you'll handle the truth.
What do you mean?
Listen, we haven't got time for this. Solidus will commence his attack any minute. He's got to be stopped.
What about the virus?
No results so far. I think the Patriots have tampered with the program.
Will it work?
I don't know.
Get me out of this thing.
Not yet. I'll release your restraints after I leave this room.
Where's my gear?
Snake's got everything. I couldn't bring it here.
And where do I find Snake?
The passageway ahead leads to a hangar. He'll be waiting there. I gave him a card key for the hangar.
Does Snake plan to destroy Arsenal gear?
No. Even for Snake, it's impossible to completely destroy this thing. The only option is to stop Solidus and his men.
What are you going to do?
Stay concealed. That's my role. I still can't afford to be discovered.
Olga, you can't keep this up. They're bound to find you.
Listen, I'll free you in a little while. Brace yourself.
Jack, are you all right?
Oh, yeah.
Jack, is it true? What Solidus said?
Yes.
It's unbelievable. Drafting small children, sending them to war? It's not allowed under international conventions.
ICC rules don't mean a lot in war. Someone told me that there are over 300,000 children in combat right now. I was just one of them.
So you remember? I thought your memory had been manipulated by them.
It was, but I have nightmares every day. Pieces of the past I can't put together.
Why didn't you tell me?
You couldn't begin to understand.
You wouldn't know that until you try me.
I didn't want you to get hurt. There was never a real reason for me to fight, except that someone put a gun in my hand. And that someone was him.
It wasn't your fault.
If I survived the day's fight, I was praised, fed, and had a bed to sleep in. I think I was only 6 when I held my first AK, but I'm not even sure of that.
Jack.
I'm not like Snake. I never questioned why we fought. There was no purpose, no way out. They give you a gun, you ask how many to kill. If you didn't, you were the one they shot instead.
It's okay. No one is blaming you.
We were shown Hollywood action films every day. The kind with macho guys and big guns. They call it image training.
Ugh.
They built us from the ground up into killing machines. We were fed once a day. I can still taste the gunpowder they mixed into the food.
Gunpowder? In the food?
The gunpowder had toluene in it, giving it hallucinogenic properties. It kept us drugged, controllable.
Oh my God!
When the Civil War ended, those of us who survived were taken in by NGOs. They gave me a new life in the States. I can't complain. But nothing's changed. The only people who have no problem with my past have secrets and agendas of their own. Terrible nightmares every night. I can never forget.
Jack.
I'm afraid of the night. That's why I don't sleep next to you.
You should have told me.
Told you what? That I'm a killer and always have been?
No, no.
What I hate more than anything else in the world is my own past. I didn't want you or anyone to know about it. Now I know why I was chosen for this mission. No one can take him on, take him down, except me. I've been kept alive this long for this. I knew as soon as I saw Solidus.
Jack, I love you the way you are now. You have to believe me. I didn't know anything about you, I admit that. Where you were born, how you grew up. But I know that now. And I know that what I feel for you can only get better. And I'll share in your past if that's the price.
It doesn't work that way. No one can share the burden of what I've done. It's not one of those warm and fuzzy things couples share.
I accept the good and the bad, Jack. That's what you do for someone you love.
I don't want to share my past with anyone. I just want to forget about it.
Jack, I haven't told you, you know, about what I've done.
The last 2 years with you, it's been more than I've ever hoped for.
Jack.
But I can't go any farther. I know you want to get married. But I can't. I can't risk starting a family. There's no way to erase my childhood.
It's all right, Jack. Please, don't say any more.
Amazing how you walk around like that. Snake! Been waiting long.
Where's my gear?
Right over there. That's more like it. Everything you had when you were captured is still there. Sorry about earlier. I had to use you as bait to gain access to Arsenal. It worked.
Why didn't you tell me about Olga?
You never asked.
Ugh.
Not happy about that? Get over it.
Any effects of the virus yet?
Still waiting on that.
So, it was rigged by the Patriots?
Looks like it. From what I can tell, Arsenal is headed for Manhattan. I don't know what Solidus is planning, but we'll have to deal with it one way or another. There's also a troop of production model Rays ahead.
How many units?
25, according to Olga.
25?
Yeah. Can't say I've faced that many Metal Gears before, but I think we can deal.
No way we can.
We can, because we have no other choice.
How?
I've stocked up on Stinger missiles. Oh yeah, Olga left this for you.
Why?
Olga asked me to give it to you. Besides, I'm not a big fan of blades. Come on, time to go. If you run out of ammo, you can have mine.
You got enough?
Absolutely. Infinite ammo.
Wait up, Snake!
What?
Snake, have you ever enjoyed killing someone?
What are you talking about?
I'm not sure. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference between reality and a game.
Diminished sense of reality, huh? VR training will do that.
No. It was field training when I was a kid. I lied, Snake. I have more field experience than I can remember. It's not VR that's doing this to me.
Raiden, we don't carry guns to take people down. We're not here to help some politician either.
You can say that because you're a legend, a hero. I'm Jack the Ripper, a dirty reminder of a terrible mistake.
Legends don't mean a whole lot. I was just a name to exploit, just like you.
People will remember only the good part, the right part of what you did.
There's no right part in murder. Not ever. And we're not in this to make a name for ourselves.
Then what are you and Otacon fighting for?
A future. You can stop being part of a mistake, starting now.
What am I? What am I supposed to do?
Find something to believe in, and find it for yourself. And when you do, pass it on to the future.
Believe in what?
That's your problem. Come on.
Snake, Raiden.
Otacon, you all right?
Yeah, so are all the hostages.
That's good news.
How's everything on your end?
All right for now. But there is something.
What?
The Colonel's last transmission was strange.
Strange? How?
Just strange. No idea.
Interference?
I don't know.
Where is this Colonel?
I don't know. I've never met the man, actually.
I'll dig around.
Thanks. I owe you one.
If there's anything else, call me on the codec. I might be able to help. The frequency is 141.12. Raiden, about this Colonel of yours. I found out where he is.
Where?
Inside Arsenal.
What?
I've checked out all the possibilities, but I keep coming back to Arsenal. It isn't a relay point, it's the origin of the signal. And the encryption protocol it uses is exactly the same as that of Arsenal's AI, the so-called GW.
What the hell does this mean?
I think it means you've been talking to an AI.
That's impossible.
The Colonel probably isn't GW per se. GW was most likely stimulating cortical activity in the dormant part of your brain through signal manipulation of your own nanomachines. The Colonel is, in part, your own creation, cobbled together from expectations and experience.
That's crazy!
But it's probably the truth. The virus may be starting to affect GW, which would explain the Colonel's behavior.
It was all an illusion? Everything I've done so far?
Raiden.
Snake, what's happening around here?
I don't know. What I do know is that you're standing right here in front of me. Not an illusion. Flesh and blood.
Huh?
It's your call. You can drop this if you want.
No, I can't do that. Let's go.
It's been a long wait.
solid, Snake. The root of all my sorrows.
What?
2 years ago, you killed my father. That was the beginning of hell for us. Everyone I love has been taken from me one by one, and no matter how hard I try, I can't follow them. An endless nightmare. The only thing we live for is to see it end. Our wait is almost over.
You can't be serious about firing the nuke.
Since no one can kill me, I may as well kill everyone I can. Starting with you, Sarah.
Damn! Looks like I'm today's pick. You go on ahead. You want eternal rest? I've got it right here. What are you gonna do? Bullets can't get near her. I'll think of something. There's no such thing as a witch.
You think you can kill me?
I don't know what your group's been through, but let's get one thing clear. I didn't kill your father.
Do you think anyone believes your lies?
Raiden, get out of here!
Jack, I've been watching how you fight. It looks like you've remembered the way you used to kill in the old days. Or is it one of the S3 plan's proud achievements?
What are you talking about?
No more games, Jack. At least you know. There's no reason to keep you alive now. I've given you a worthy opponent, at least. But now, you should die as the little Jackie boy I once knew.
Hold them off. Give you time to get away.
What about you? This is suicide!
Your nanomachines, they're transmitting your vital signs to the Patriots. If you die, my child dies. You understand? The child.
I see. So that's why you sold your troops out to me. So many dead, and they all died trusting you! Were they your comrades?
No, not just comrades. Family! I know I'm going to help, but at least my child.
I applaud your attitude. If you have a death wish, I'll be happy to accommodate you. See you in hell!
Ah!
enjoy the show, Jack? Let's pick up where we left off. What's going on? What's wrong with it?
AI. GW, it's out of control.
What? What happened?
Maybe some kind of virus.
The Patriots?
I don't know.
Ocelot, what have you been up to?
It's too late. Arsenal's system control is going haywire. It's on an emergency ascent course.
Stupid machines! Are you awake yet, Jack? GW, the Arsenal AI is corrupted beyond repair. I admit that I underestimated you. I'll squeeze the answers out of you instead, my son! It's not him I want the answers from.
What do you mean?
That's not your business.
Oh, really? It so happens I have some business of my own to attend to.
Planning to hijack Arsenal?
Huh?
You were going to screw me over, weren't you?
Who talked? Ocelot?
Not exactly. I was the one who used Ocelot to suggest the idea to you in the first place.
What?
I was planning to give you Arsenal to begin with.
Why the uncharacteristic generosity?
I'm no philanthropist. Arsenal is far from impregnable. It needs other Metal Gears as guards, a huge payload of warheads, and full air, sea, and land support to function efficiently. Against a large attack force without support, Arsenal is nothing more than a gigantic coffin.
Seizing Arsenal gear was never the real objective.
What was your objective then?
A list of names of the Patriots. They were planning to extend their control to digital information flow with GW and Arsenal. That means the information they want to filter out is contained in GW. Including that list of the highest 12 members of the Patriots Wiseman's Committee.
And once you knew who they were, you would cross out their names one by one. While we, with our useless arsenal, drew their fire.
Very good.
You were using us all along.
Were you any different?
But your plans hit a snag with GW destroyed, hasn't it?
No, there is another way.
Really? But we have our own plans to carry out. We'll take the arsenal since you don't care for it anyway. The purified hydrogen bomb is ready to go.
A nuclear strike won't stop them.
It will damage their power source. The mindless masses that they control. First things first.
Of course. That was what you wanted. I won't stop you. Good luck.
Thanks, but I have quite enough of that. What exactly do you find so funny?
Charades usually are humorous. I wouldn't have minded watching some more of it, but we're running a little short on time.
What are you talking about?
Everything you've done here has been scripted. A little exercise set up by us.
Exercise?
The S3 plan was conceived as a means to produce soldiers on par with Solid Snake. That's what I told you. But the VR training the boy was put through is not the meat of the project. You think this little terrorist incident is your own doing, Solidus? This is the S3 training kernel. An orchestrated recreation of Shadow Moses.
What?
Ames and the President's deaths. The ninja. The computer virus that mimics Fox Dye. Did you really think they were all a coincidence? AIM's own nanomachines were used to shut down his pacemaker. I arranged for the appearance of the ninja as well. As for the president, although Johnson realized what was going on, he played out his allotted part. As for the computer virus, it's a digital counterpart of FoxDye. It was also designed to eliminate every scrap of information regarding the Patriots from GW. Your plan was invalidated even before execution, Solidus. Fat Man was a different story. He's one of our own people, a sort of examiner we hired to test the boy's progress before letting him tackle the exercise proper. We had to arrange for Stillman's presence to coax the maniac into agreeing. If the boy had allowed the Big Shell to be destroyed, this exercise would have ended there. The project has no room for failures.
What do you mean?
Given the right situation, the right story, anyone can be shaped into Snake. Even rookies can fight like men of experience. An instant creation of genius! And this training kernel will provide more than enough data to formulate such a program. You, Dead Cell, Olga, you're all nothing but pawns placed to create the perfect simulation. Solidus. You and the boy were selected because your relationship resembles the one between Snake and Big Boss. Fortune, you and the rest of Dead Cell stand in for the Foxhound squad that Snake took on in Shadow Moses. You're the most impressive collection of freaks outside of Foxhound. We've gone to a lot of trouble to set you up against the boy. That story about purified hydrogen bombs is just the tip of the iceberg. The project was already underway when I sunk that tanker, along with your old man 2 years ago. Throwing your husband in the brig was a part of it, too. You were told that the eradication of Dead Cell 6 months ago was an act of the Patriots. We provoked and encouraged your hatred. And you opted for vengeance, just as we planned.
All orchestrated?
Except for the appearance of the real Solid Snake. I wonder now who sent for you.
All our misfortune was just a part of your project? How could...
You're no Lady Luck. You have nothing that we didn't give you. Why no bullet could hit you? It wasn't magic, or some new age mumbo-jumbo. Certainly wasn't your psychic talents. It was all staged by the Patriots.
Staged?
You were being shielded by the electromagnetic weapons technology that the Patriots developed. Your Dead Cell comrades loved your father and husband. We needed a pathetic wretch like you to keep them focused. You've been our puppet all along, just like Olga.
No!
You were hamming it up as the tragic heroine, thanks to the script that the Patriots wrote for you. Pure self-indulgence, absorbed in your own misfortune. You couldn't get enough of the drama.
I could have died whenever I wanted to.
Thought I got her in the heart.
It missed.
Now I remember. Your heart's on the right. Waste of metal, my dear, but your luck's run out. This is the little gizmo. There's no such thing as miracles or the supernatural, only cutting-edge technology. Retrieve Arsenal and clean up the refuse from the exercise.
Just try.
This then.
away from there.
I told you, your luck's run out. Take your reward. It's all the payload Ray has. Die!
Everybody down!
Inside this arm all along, waiting for the right time to awaken.
You were inside Ocelot?
Yes, a sleeper in the arm of a Patriot spy.
It was you 2 years ago?
Exactly. I was controlling him. Snake, it was I that leaked information about Arsenal to your partner and got you out here.
What?
You're the only one that can free me. After all... I'm off to bury the Patriots for good.
You know where they are? How?
Why do you think I chose Ocelot as my host? But before I go, I have a family matter to settle with both of you. There's room for only one Snake and one big boss. Time to say goodbye!
Damn!
Like surfing, it's a good way to go.
day it is today.
April 30th?
That's right. George Washington took office as the first president of the United States of America 200 years ago today. And it happened right here. We were going to declare another independence, the dawn of a new nation, here. The end of the Patriots' secret rule, liberation of this country. This was where it was supposed to begin. This is where freedom could have been born.
All you want is power at any cost.
Jack, it's not power I want. What I wanted to take back from the Patriots are things like freedom, civil rights, opportunities. The founding principles of this country. Everything that's about to be wiped out by their digital censorship. Jack, listen to me. We're all born with an expiration date. No one lasts forever. Life is nothing but a grace period for turning the best of our genetic material into the next generation. The data of life is transferred from parent to child. That's how it works. But we have no heirs, no legacy. We brothers are called les enfants terribles, cloned from our father, with the ability to reproduce conveniently engineered out. What is our legacy if we cannot pass the torch? Proof of our existence, a mark of some sort. When the torch is passed on from parent to child, it extends beyond DNA. Information is imparted as well. All I want is to be remembered by other people, by history. The Patriots are trying to protect their power, their own interests, by controlling the digital flow of information. I want my memory, my existence to remain. Unlike an intron of history, I will be remembered as an exon. That will be my legacy, my mark in history. But the Patriots would deny us even that. I will triumph over the Patriots and liberate us all, and we will become the Sons of Liberty!
Raiden, are you receiving? We're still here.
How's that possible? The AI was destroyed.
Only GW.
Who are you?
To begin with, we're not what you'd call human. Over the past 200 years, a kind of consciousness formed layer by layer in the crucible of the White House. It's not unlike the way life started in the oceans 4 billion years ago. The White House was our primordial soup, a base of evolution. We are formless. We are the very discipline and morality that Americans invoke so often. How can anyone hope to eliminate us? As long as this nation exists, so will we.
Cut the crap! If you're immortal, why would you take away individual freedoms and censor the net?
Jack, don't be silly.
Don't you know that our plans have your interests, not ours, in mind?
What?
Jack, listen carefully, like a good boy.
The mapping of the human genome was completed early this century. As a result, the evolutionary log of the human race lay open to us.
We started with genetic engineering, and in the end, we succeeded in digitizing life itself.
But there are things not covered by genetic information.
What do you mean?
Human memories, ideas, culture, history.
Genes don't contain any record of human history.
Is it something that should not be passed on? Should that information be left at the mercy of nature?
We've always kept records of our lives, through words, pictures, symbols, from tablets to books.
But not all the information was inherited by later generations. A small percentage of the whole was selected and processed, then passed on. Not unlike genes, really.
That's what history is, Jack.
But in the current digitized world, trivial information is accumulating every second, preserved in all its triteness, never fading, always accessible.
Rumors about petty issues, misinterpretations, slander.
All this junk data, preserved in an unfiltered state, growing at an alarming rate.
It will only slow down social progress, reduce the rate of evolution.
Right. You seem to think that our plan is one of censorship.
Are you telling me it's not?
You're being silly. What we propose to do is not to control content, but to create context.
Create context?
The digital society furthers human flaws and selectively rewards development of convenient half-truths. Just look at the strange juxtapositions of morality around you.
Billions spent on new weapons in order to humanely murder other humans.
Rights of criminals are given more respect than the privacy of their victims.
Although there are people suffering in poverty, huge donations are made to protect endangered species. Everyone grows up being told the same thing.
Be nice to other people.
But beat out the competition.
You're special. Believe in yourself and you will succeed.
But it's obvious from the start that only a few can succeed.
You exercise your right to freedom, and this is the result. All rhetoric to avoid conflict and protect each other from hurt. The untested truths, spun by different interests, continue to churn and accumulate in the sandbox of political correctness and value systems.
Everyone withdraws into their own small gated community, afraid of a larger forum. They stay inside their little ponds, leaking whatever truth suits them into the growing cesspool of society at large.
The different cardinal truths neither clash nor mesh. No one is invalidated, but nobody is right.
Not even natural selection can take place here. The world is being engulfed in truth.
And this is the way the world ends. Not with a bang, but a whimper.
We're trying to stop that from happening.
It's our responsibility as rulers. Just as in genetics, unnecessary information and memory must be filtered out to stimulate the evolution of the species.
And you think you're qualified to decide what's necessary and not?
Absolutely. Who else could wade through the sea of garbage you people produce, retrieve valuable truths, and even interpret their meaning for later generations?
That's what it means to create context.
I'll decide for myself what to believe and what to pass on.
But is that even your own idea?
Or something Snake told you?
That's the proof of your incompetence right there. You lack the qualifications to exercise free will.
That's not true. I have the right.
Does something like a self exist inside of you?
That which you call self serves as nothing more than a mask to cover your own being.
In this era of ready-made truths, self is just something used to preserve those positive emotions that you occasionally feel.
Another possibility is that self is a concept you conveniently borrowed under the logic that it would endow you with some sense of strength.
That's crap!
Is it? Would you prefer that someone else tell you? All right, then. Explain it to him.
Jack, you're simply the best. And you got there all by yourself.
Oh, what happened? Do you feel lost? Why not try a bit of soul searching?
Don't think you'll find anything, though.
Ironic that although self is something that you yourself fashion, every time something goes wrong, you turn around and place the blame on something else.
It's not my fault. It's not your fault.
In denial, you simply resort to looking for another, more convenient truth in order to make yourself feel better.
Leaving behind in an instant the so-called truth you once embraced.
Should someone like that be able to decide what is truth?
Should someone like you even have the right to decide?
You've done nothing but abuse your freedom.
You don't deserve to be free.
We're not the ones smothering the world. You are.
The individual is supposed to be weak, but far from powerless. A single person has the potential to ruin the world.
And the age of digitized communication has given even more power to the individual. Too much power for an immature species.
Building a legacy involves figuring out what is wanted and what needs to be done for that goal. All this you used to struggle with. Now, we think for you.
We are your guardians, after all.
You want to control human thought? Human behavior?
Of course. Anything can be quantified nowadays. That's what this exercise was designed to prove.
You fell in love with me just as you were meant to, after all. Isn't that right, Jack?
Ocelot was not told the whole truth, to say the least.
We rule an entire nation. Of what interest would a single soldier, no matter how able, be to us?
The S3 plan does not stand for solid snake simulation. What it does stand for is selection for societal sanity. The S3 is a system for controlling human will and consciousness. S3 is not you, a soldier trained in the image of Solid Snake. It is a method, a protocol that created a circumstance that made you what you are.
So you see, we're the S3, not you.
What you experienced was the final test of its effectiveness.
That's crazy!
You heard what President Johnson said.
The Arsenal's GW system is the key to their supremacy.
The objective of this exercise was to establish such a method. We used Shadow Moses as a paradigm for the exercise.
I wonder if you would have preferred a fantasy setting.
We chose that backdrop because of its extreme circumstances. It was an optimal test for S3's crisis management capacity. If the model could trigger, control, and solve this, it would be ready for any contingency. And now, we have our proof. Raiden, there are also reasons behind your selection. Solidus raised plenty of other child soldiers. Do you know why we chose you over them? It was because you were the only one who refused to acknowledge the past. All the others remember what they were and pay for it daily.
But you turn your back on everything you don't like. You do whatever you like, see only the things you like, and for yourself alone.
Yes, Rose can attest to that.
You refused to see me for what I was. I lied to you, but I wanted to be caught. You pretended to be understanding, to be a gentleman. You never made a conscious attempt to reach out to me. The only time you did was when I gave you no choice but to do so.
I was just trying not to...
What? Trying not to hurt me? Dear, the one you were trying not to hurt was yourself. Avoiding the truth under the guise of kindness is all that you did. It occurred to you to do nothing but look out for yourself. Even if you claim that it was for my sake, that feeling was nowhere to be seen. In the end, everything was for your sake. I was never part of the picture.
Exactly right. So you see, you're a perfect representative of the masses we need to protect. This is why we chose you. You accepted the fiction we've provided, obeyed our orders, and did everything you were told to. The exercise is a resounding success.
Didn't I tell you that GW was still incomplete? But not anymore, thanks to you.
Your persona, experiences, triumphs, and defeats are nothing but byproducts. The real objective was ensuring that we could generate and manipulate them. It's taken a lot of time and money, but it was well worth it considering the results. I think that's enough talk. It's time for the final exercise. Raiden, take Solidus down.
Think again. I'm through doing what I'm told.
Oh, really? Aren't you forgetting something?
If you die, my child dies.
The termination of vital signals from your nanomachines means the death of Olga's child. Not to mention the death of Rose. She's wired the same way.
Rose, does she actually exist?
Of course I do, Jack. You have to believe me.
Damn!
It will be a fight to the death.
Solidus at least wants you dead.
We will collect the necessary data from this last fight. Then we'll consider the exercise closed. So, Jack the Ripper, will it be Solidus The Patriot's creation, or you, Solidus's creation? Our beloved monsters, enjoy yourselves.
Jack, my son. My clone brothers and I are called monsters, replicates of evil genes. You are one of a kind, but still a monster, shaped by a dark and secret history. We need to decide which monstrosity will have the privilege of survival. By the way, Jack, I was the one who killed your parents. I claimed you for my own and raised you as a soldier in the army of the devil. I am your foster father and your worst enemy.
Why?
Because I needed to know whether we were really someone else's creation. We're repeating history, Jack. Liquid and Solid hunted down Big Boss, trying to sever the tie that bound them to him. Unless you kill me and face your past, Jack, you will never escape. You'll stay in the endless loop. Your own double helix. It's time we were both free. I have other reasons for wanting you dead. The clues to the Patriots inside GW have been erased, but there are other traces. Inside you.
What?
The information is being carried by the nanomachines in your cerebral cortex and throughout the neural network they formed. Thank you.
Light knows who or what they are. The memories you have and the role you were assigned are burdens you had to carry. It doesn't matter if they were real or not. That's never the point. There's no such thing in the world as absolute reality. Most of what they call real is actually fiction. What you think you see is only as real as your brain tells you it is.
Then, what am I supposed to believe in? What am I going to leave behind when I'm through?
We can tell other people about having faith. What we had faith in. What we found important enough to fight for. It's not whether you are right or wrong, but how much faith you are willing to have that decides the future. The Patriots are a kind of ongoing fiction too, come to think of it. Listen, don't obsess over words so much. Find the meaning behind the words, then decide. You can find your own name and your own future.
Decide for myself?
And whatever you choose will be you.
I don't know if I can.
I know you didn't have much in terms of choices this time. But everything you felt, thought about during this mission is yours. And what you decide to do with them is your choice.
You mean start over?
Yeah, a clean slate, a new name, new memories. Choose your own legacy. It's for you to decide. It's up to you. By the way, what is that?
Dog tags.
Anyone you know?
No, never heard the name before. I'll pick my own name and my own life. I'll find something worth passing on. They taught me some good things, too.
I know. We've inherited freedom from all those who fought for it. We all have the freedom to spread the word, even me.
Snake, what about Olga's child?
Don't worry. I'll find him. Count on it. As long as you keep yourself alive, he's safe.
Do you know where Liquid went?
I put a transmitter on his ray.
Did he head for the Patriots?
Yeah, but I have a feeling they gave Ocelot a bogus location to begin with. Cheer up. We have a better lead. This contains the list of all the Patriots.
But Ocelot took it.
The one we gave you wasn't the real thing.
What?
This virus is coded to destroy only a specific part of GW, namely the information about the Patriots' identity. Which means that there's a parameter coded in here that defines what that information is.
I get it. Analyze the code and you can probably find out where they operate. Count me in.
No, you have things to do first. And people you need to talk to.
I ask you something? Who am I, really?
I wouldn't know. But we're going to find out together, aren't we?
Oh. Yeah.
See me for what I am, okay?
I know.
Do you remember this place?
Of course. This is where we first met. I remember now. Mm-hmm. Today is the day I met you.
That's it.
I think I found something to pass along to the future.
What?
He said all living things want their genes to live on.
Are you talking about the baby?
Yeah. The genes aren't the only thing you pass on. There are too many things that aren't written into our DNA. It's up to us to teach that to our children.
What kind of things?
About the environment, our ideas, our culture, poetry, compassion, sorrow, joy. We'll tell them everything together.
Is that a proposal?
This is for your ears only.
Thank you. dreams that I let slip away, I'll find the joyfulness I'm looking for way back in yesterday.
Life isn't just about passing on your genes. We can leave behind much more than just DNA. Through speech, music, literature, and movies, what we've seen, heard, felt, anger, joy, and sorrow. These are the things I will pass on. That's what I live for. We need to pass the torch and let our children read our messy and sad history by its light. We have all the magic of the digital age to do that with. The human race will probably come to an end sometime, and new species may rule over this planet. Earth may not be forever, but we still have the responsibility to leave what traces of life we can. Building the future and keeping the past alive are one and the same thing.